Have you ever wondered why some mood boards look cohesive and organized while others look like a bunch of pictures thrown together? Well, today I'm going to show you how you can create a mood board that's organized in a unique and consistent way to help you or your client visualize the design of an interior space. Stay till the end of the video to get access to assets and additional tips to make your mood board stand out. Now, let's get started. You can create a mood board using different tools like Illustrator, Photoshop, or Canva. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Illustrator and Photoshop to create your mood board. The first thing we're going to do is create an artboard in Illustrator, then import your inspirations onto the artboard. These can be pictures you found from Pinterest, design websites, or other social media that inspires and represent your ideas and design style. Next, isolate the objects by removing the background from the image. To do this, you can use the Adobe Background Remover tool on the Adobe website. Just press Upload your photo and drag and drop the image you want to edit. Sometimes the tool doesn't recognize the image if it has a busy background. In this case, crop the image to help the tool detect the object better. Then upload the crop image and Adobe will automatically remove the background of the image. Download the image and import it to your project. Now it's clean and easy to work with. Another problem you might face is types of furniture that are not clearly shown or obstructed by another object. For this, you can use Google Lens to search for the same furniture with a better picture. Just press the lens icon and upload the image you want to search. And there you have it, multiple images of the same couch, but with better pictures and a clean background. And if you go to the site, you can even choose different angles of the same picture. Do the same for all the types of furniture you want to use and when you find what you're looking for. Download the image and import them to your project. All the images should be clean with the background removed. After that, start adjusting the images on the mood board. Here, I'm making two art boards with different perspectives, front and side profiles, so I'll arrange the images accordingly. Only place images that fit the perspective you're trying to create. As you can see for the mood board on the left, all the images of the furniture are taken from an angle, and I'm not going to use images showing the front view of the furniture. Those kind of images are used on the other mood board, where I'm trying to show a front profile. Another thing you can do to highlight the perspective and 3D effect of the mood board is to edit the flooring material we're going to use in Photoshop. To do so, import an image of the floor material you're planning to use. Adjust the scale, duplicate it to the size you want by holding Alt and dragging the image, and merge the layers by selecting all the layers you duplicated and right-click and select Merge Layers. Then go to the Edit tab and select Transform. Then skew the floor and start adjusting the image to the perspective you want. It's a good idea to import an image from your board like this couch here to help you match the perspective of the floor with the perspective of the objects in your mood board. Do the same for the wall and make sure it's aligned with the floor you've just created. Use the selection tool to select and the eraser tool to remove excess material that doesn't align with your new wall. Here I'm doing the same thing for the other mood board I'm creating. The only difference here is the perspective. After you're done, save the floor you've just created as a PNG file. By going to File, Export, Export As, then choose PNG from the format dropdown and press Export. Next, import the floor and wall material you've just made to the mood board and adjust the furniture around it. If there's an image that doesn't quite fit the angles of your mood board, you can try mirroring the images by right-clicking on it, select Transform, then reflect with 90 degrees. Don't be afraid to swap or try different styles of furniture as long as it goes with the aesthetics you're creating. Understanding scale is important when creating this type of mood board, because you want to create an immersive presentation that is closer to a finished design. Some PNG files might have big border around a small image, like this chandelier, so make sure to crop the image. This floor lamp looks out of place, so let me swap it with a different one. Here the images are taking over the entire mood board. Let me scale them down a bit. So what I'm doing here is trying different elements and placement that helps communicate my idea better. That's why you see me going back and forth on my decisions. I'm trying out different things, and I encourage you to do the same. When adding a new element on the floor or wall, like the carpet here, you should adjust the perspective of the image like we did on the floor material. You can also add a border to the floor by using the pen tool and highlighting the edges. This will add to the 3D effect we're trying to create. Now let's create a color palette to show the colors that are important to the design. Create a shape that fits your design. And by using the eyedrop tool, select the colors that are represented in your design. Stick to the major ones. Then find a good place to put your color palettes. Next, we'll add material, textures, and patterns that are used in the design. Take a sample from the elements in your design or search online for textures that are the same as the ones in your design and place them in the mood board. Whenever you add a new element, think about how it affects the flow of the board you've already created and adjust accordingly. Add some finishing elements and you're done. Save your file by going to File, Save As, and from the options, choose PDF and press Save. And since you made it to the end, as promised, here are some extra tips for creating the best mood board. Don't be afraid to experiment. There are no right or wrong answers when it comes to creating a mood board. Just have fun and let your creativity flow. Use a variety of sources. Don't just rely on one source for your inspiration. Use multiple of sources to get a wider range of ideas. Keep it simple. Don't overcrowd your mood board. Too many images can be overwhelming. Use high-quality images. Poor quality images will make your mood board look unprofessional. Have fun. Creating a mood board should be a fun and creative process. Don't take it too seriously. You can find a link to download this project file and all its elements in the description. And if you learn anything new, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel.